Are you getting Windows detected that the EFI system partition was formatted as NTFS error message while installing Windows? Then you are at the right place as you have the ways to fix the issue. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. While installing Windows, some users encountered the error Windows detected that the EFI system partition was formatted as NTFS. This error terminated the Windows installation process and users could not install Windows. If you encounter the same error while installing Windows, follow this video to resolve the issue. Method 1. Format the EFI system partition as FAT32. The first fix is to format the EFI system partition as FAT32. First, note down the size of the system partition. While installing Windows, all the partitions are displayed including recovery, EFI, and other partitions. From here, you can note the size of the EFI system partition. Press the Shift plus F10 keys on the Windows installation screen to open the command prompt. Now type notepad and hit enter. This will open the notepad. Go to the file, then open to access File Explorer directly from the Windows installation screen. Select this PC and then select the EFI system partition. This EFI system partition should be of the same size you saw on the installation screen. Right-click on it and select Format. Select FAT32 in the File System drop-down and format the selected partition. Be careful while selecting the partition during formatting, as an incorrect selection will erase your crucial data. Exit and close File Explorer, Command Prompt and Notepad. Now click on Refresh on the installation screen and proceed with the installation. Method 2. Delete all critical partitions. If your system has multiple partitions including the system partition, recovery partition, etc., it is better to delete all of them. On the installation screen, select the system partition and all other critical partitions. The partitions that do not have a drive letter and have a size typically in MB. After that, delete the partition you want to install Windows to create an unallocated space. Select the partition with an unallocated space and proceed with the Windows installation. The error should not occur this time. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.